Biodiesel right after it is made is likely to contain methanol, soap, and free glycerin, all of which should be removed to ensure its quality. There are several methods of doing this, but water washing is one of the most effective and most frequently used. Except for distillation, most of the techniques used to purify biodiesel rely on the difference in molecular polarity between the methyl esters in biodiesel and the contaminants. Methanol, soap, and glycerin are all polar and are thus strongly attracted to each other and to polar solvents such as water. Methyl esters are only slightly polar and thus have limited solubility in water. When water is sprayed into biodiesel, it generally forms a separate phase of water droplets. Since methanol, soap, and free glycerin are more strongly attracted to the water, they selectively partition into the water phase. When the water phase is removed, either by gravity settling or centrifugation, the impurities are removed with water, and the concentrations of the contaminants in biodiesel will be reduced. Frequently, multiple cycles of washing are required to achieve sufficiently low levels of the contaminants. However, some producers avoid water washing to reduce wastewater, emulsion risk, and complexity in recycling methanol. Adsorbents are an alternative to water washing, but are mostly effective for low soap concentrations at elevated temperatures. Ion exchange resins are another option, but are expensive. Distillation is becoming a more popular purification technique, but it involves high energy cost, loses some of the material, and doesn't remove free glycerin. Water washing has its own disadvantages, but when properly conducted, it is a robust technique that uses no costly materials, can handle high contaminant levels, and reduces methanol, soap, and glycerin to levels that meet the ASTM spec. If patience and proper care are used, it can be executed with minimal problems, even in high-volume production operations. Read the full TechNote 25 online at www.biodieseleducation.org.